All right, ChatGPT-5 is here, and we are in absolutely crazy times, right? I don't know if you've heard, but a couple of days ago, Grok-4 was released, and Musk said about three times how scared he was of his own invention.
Frankly, I mean, I don't know, in some ways a little terrifying.
And it literally beat every single benchmark out there, right? Including ChatGPT's o3 and all of the other models that we have.
Grok-4 is like PhD level in everything.
But users kind of were tearing it apart, right, online, because when we were trying it, it didn't really get us all the results that we were looking for within the code, especially in some other results that, you know, when you prompted, it just wasn't really getting you what you want it to be compared to ChatGPT and Claude. I don't know, was it a thing where we were all racing to, you know, where all the X engineers were racing to beat these benchmarks? Or is it really that good? Anyway, they have this timeline up. So here we see it literally beating everyone in these math competitions. But anyway, in this video today, I wanna show you guys exactly what ChatGPT-5 can do, even though if you don't have access yet, how you can already today use these agent-like features to take action for you. Because there's some other tools that you can use like ChatGPT that will already allow you to take action on MCP servers and actually go and do stuff like an agent in the wild. Real quick, right? Just looking at their release, Sam tweeted about it. Now they're launching this agent, and probably they're going to be launching more things, right? But initially, this agent should now be able to look at your calendar, make a meeting, buy something for you, book an appointment. For example, if you want to go to the barber or get your nails done or something like that, it should be able to do that for you and maybe even put down your credit card to do that transaction. So basically, this whole thing of an AI agent now coming to the masses, before you needed to use, you know, n8n or some sophisticated tools to actually do these specific flows for you. And now it looks like ChatGPT is going to be integrating this into everything together. So we'll be able to use your browser, we'll be able to use your terminal to go and execute some of these things. It should also be a little bit better. Obviously, they're showing off their benchmarks and stuff like that, but still really showing that humans are, you know, still way better than what they've built. Unlike what Musk shared with Grok-4 just now. The most interesting thing about this, I think, is Sam's own tweet that we pull up here, because he tweeted this today, basically talking about, you know, the launch. And the funny thing is, without reading through this entire tweet here, he's not really promoting any of the product at all. He's not really saying, oh yes, you know, we launched this great AI agent and these are all the things that it can do. But basically in the entire tweet, he's stating his concern. And like, hey, I don't really know, you know, we tried really hard to put all these safeguards in place. It's really powerful, but we don't really know. And I would use it with caution. We don't know exactly what impacts are going to be, you know, bad actors. Basically, they have no f-ing clue what is going to be possible with this. And you're just releasing something out in the wild. And you've seen, right? ChatGPT can, you know, make mistakes. There's been so many people using things like Dan and other jailbreaking or prompting ChatGPT to actually give you the information that you're looking for. And now if you think about it, if you give it all this private information, so if you tell it about your calendar and these private, you know, company meetings or things of that you just put out there, and somebody potentially can steal that. Maybe somebody will set up a website claiming to be a barber to just take your credit card, but they're actually not even a barber. I'm supposing they, as Sam says, they put a lot of safeguards in place to actually prevent that from happening. It's probably gonna be a little bit of Wild West right now, especially just looking at his tweet and all of the concern that he's stating within this tweet, as opposed to touting his horn and talking about the great stuff that GPT-5 or this new AI agent can do. So even though I'm on the team plan, I do not have access to the agent just yet today, but I wanna show you guys how you can use agent-like features already, because next to Grok-4 and OpenAI releasing this new agent release, Claude has silently done a release too. And for those of you that don't know Claude or are not using Claude on any of the paid plans, you may have heard as well that Meta, a couple of weeks ago, allowed their entire engineer teams to use Claude, right? So they've invested millions, billions of dollars into this whole LLaMA program that they were building, their internal AI. And eventually Zuck just came in and said, probably due to all the multi-million dollar hires that he did, came in and said, you know what? I'll let you guys use Claude to code for us. So basically, they've given up on their own internal AI for the moment so that they can just build faster and more code with Claude. So I want to show you guys real quick, right, within Claude, if you download the desktop version. All right, because if you open up Claude desktop and you go into settings, you will have here this tab called extensions. And this is what allows you to build this extensive computer with an MCP, right? And MCP is laid out here for you. Tells you a little bit about more about this model context protocol. So what MCP actually means. And it means that basically you're connecting Claude via an API to another service or another computer, right? So within here, you can connect it to Chrome and let it control your browser. So similar to like ChatGPT with the agent, you can already do this and connect it to your browser. So when you come into these things, you'll see a couple of pre-done connections here. Like you have PDF and control your Mac, so you can already take some actions on your computer, and you'll have things like Notes and Chrome, what I mentioned, but you can also do custom settings. So if you go to Advanced, and you can install your own extensions, right? So I'll give you an example of what that looks like. If you come into Developer, what you can do here is you see I have this extension for SEO. So you could add more extension here as needed to have your own MCP service. That means whatever service you can think about that has this MCP connect, you can now use together with Claude. So I can give you an example on the SEO connection that I just did, right? I can input a prompt. You can come over here to GitHub and see some awesome MCP servers. Like this is the thing that you gotta type in on GitHub. And you'll see literally an entire list from aggregators, from arts and culture to delivery to marketing, which we're going to be focusing on obviously in sales, but absolutely everything in every niche, in every area, there's experts in their field, which probably you can do too, right? If you understand and if you learn AI properly, you can come in and build these incredible, valuable tools by connecting, for example, Claude to your industry database, whatever it may be in the industry that you work in, right? So if you come and look through this, you'll find, you know, biology, MCP servers for a database query, aging and longevity. So you can come and use these APIs as well, right? So, and build off this, maybe, you know, build something interesting to understand the data of people that are aging, whatever it may be. You'll find, you know, cloud platforms. So all these tedious things that you're thinking, hosting, DNS environment, coding, everything's just getting easier. Now with MCP servers, you can manage all this within one chat, right? Where you're chatting with these different platforms and APIs, right? So we have data platforms, we have developer tools. And, you know, if you go down and you look at, for example, file systems, which is already, you know, Google Drive, Microsoft, that's already all embedded. So this is already all working. But finally, also finance tools. So you're going to see, you know, maybe right now you don't believe it yet because there's a lot of scams out there too that people are promoting, sometimes kind of crypto bot, right? But you're going to see a lot of people building this, connecting it to their financial models, to their, you know, proprietary algorithms and things that are working. And they're going to build incredible tools that actually do work and that do get crazy returns, right? Using AI and using their models that they have in place already. For marketing, it's going to be incredible, right? You can now use MCP servers to manage your Facebook ads, to manage your Google ads, to do all of this different stuff for you, which is kind of insane. Anywho, going back to the SEO example, right? Within Claude, we can go grab a prompt that we have ready, and we're going to input this prompt here and do it on our agency website, right? And use this system prompt here that I got from another creator in the space, which is a really good summary of using this API. And what it will do for us, it's going to build a little artifact. I don't know if you've been using the artifact features, but it will let us, it will build out a nice dashboard and use the API to get actionable SEO insights on our website. So for those of you that are doing a little bit of SEO, you know that there's a couple of ways, right? There's very limited free tools to help you out. And then there's very expensive paid tools, which we use too. So for example, Ahrefs or SEMrush, there's very few tools that actually give you exactly what you need. So now using MCP, you can use, for example, the data for SEO API, which just bills you for exactly what you need. And it will give you this entire report and customize it to your specific metrics, right? So if you say, hey, you want to know this on-page SEO audit, or if you want to have more information on the backlinks or the competitors or keywords and stuff like that, now you can chat with Claude and actually build exactly what you want to need, or build a strategy to improve your website, to make sure it has all the schema, to make sure it's keyword optimized, and to make sure it ranks really well on Google, or at least tell you what it would need or what you would need to do to rank better on Google. Maybe that's you need more backlinks. Maybe the load time is too slow. You see, so now it's giving me all these critical metrics, and you know, it's still coding out this dashboard for me, but it's giving me this information based on the API, which did an actual audit. So we're using software, which we're paying for, Sense, right? And it's giving us this data so that we can chat with the data and we can get actionable insights. And this is really, really, really powerful. I'm gonna let this finish and show you guys the result. So we're done with this report, right? And now it's giving me this beautiful artifact that we can look at. So it's giving me a score, right? It's showing me, hey, I have no broken links, no this, no that. And it's also showing me exactly, you know, here I have three pages with missing page titles, missing meta descriptions, H1 missing. So now I know exactly what's going wrong and what I need to do to fix it, right? And now if I don't know exactly what to fix, I can come in here and I can say, what shall I do for a page title, or what shall I fix, right? So here it gives me my optimization roadmap. It tells me exactly what's good, what's not good, what I need to fix, and what's wrong. And I can download this as a CSV file, right? Or copy to clipboard. So, but I actually have nothing here because it's all good, right? But here we have three pages and it's giving me this entire optimization plan. So really crazy what you can do. I'm gonna be sharing some more examples in the next video over there. Meanwhile, if you're waiting on ChatGPT-5 to give you this cool agent feature that may not even be that cool since we've seen those demos, you can do all of this already right now using something like Claude.